Megadeth with Angry Again, folks. Speaking of Angry Again, here comes Eddie Cochran's Nervous Breakdown. If you've got a little extra time this weekend, stop by the Lansing Film Festival. See what's happening on the indie film scene. Chilly weather on the forecast, so get your jackets.
Serious, man, she does.
No, why did you break up?
I don't know.
I'm sorry, man.
Me too.
Is it permanent?
Permanent is a dead horse, amigo.
Did you do something?
Why do you say that?
Because I know you.
You think I'm a dick?
No. I think you occasionally have a tendency to act in a phallic fashion.
I'm not like that anymore.
Oh, what? You're not a dick?
See what I mean?
I'm just asking, man. What happened?
Lots of things.
Like?
Like, she thinks I'm reckless.
In general?
Yes.
Were you at all specifically reckless recently?
Not particularly specifically.
Be honest.
I am.
Did you fuck around?
No.
Vince?
I didn't.
So then what happened?
She says I have violent tendencies.
Oh boy.
I never touched her, John.
I didn't say you did.
It's just that she thinks I have unresolved issues which occasionally manifest themselves in potentially violent ways. Huh. What?
I think it's fair to say she has a point.
Well, no one's saying she doesn't have a point.
So
she has to break up with me?
She's probably scared.
Of what? I never threatened her.
Dude, you present a threatening appearance.
We've been together for like 3 years.
So?
So you think she'd be used to it by now?
It's a tricky one, Ben.
What are you talking about?
I'm just saying, it's tricky, okay? I mean, look, women these days, they've got no reason to hang around with potentially violent guys, you know? It's not a very attractive trait to them anymore. There's too many other guys out there with resolved violent tendencies.
So I'm just out of fashion.
Don't be a fool.
Well, don't be a politically correct fuck.
I'm not. I'm telling you, you're an idiot if you think chicks are gonna put up with your bullshit.
What bullshit?
Like playing rough?
I didn't play rough with her.
Oh, Vince.
What?
I love you,
good.
But come on.
What?
You don't not play rough.
I totally do not play rough.
You're swarthy.
That's a stereotype.
True.
You bigot.
I can't be a bigot. I'm a Jew.
I know plenty of Jewish bigots.
Like who?
Irving Berlin.
Oh, God. Okay. You know what? Let's just move on to the next subject.
Fine.
All right. You know, I'm sorry you guys broke up. Really, I'm sorry for you both.
Well, don't be sorry for that bitch.
Okay, fine. I'm just sorry for you. Next subject?
She says if I stop being a dick and stick with the meetings, she'll consider talking to me again.
Good. Should we get some dinner?
You gotta wait for a call.
From who?
None of your business.
Leah?
Nope.
Okay.
So you ready for tomorrow?
Are you mad?
No.
You're lying,
baby. I'm not mad. I'll find someone else who appreciates my dark side.
Exactly. Ah, just the thing is, I mean, if you could find a way to learn something from this, then you wouldn't have such a large dark side.
Learn what?
Learn to deal with some of your violent desires, man. Oh. By acknowledging them, okay? By making some sort of truce with yourself so you're not always in this constant battle to prove your integrity or self-worth or whatever it is that you think that nobody gets about you.
Well, I don't really think there's much to get about me, John. I'm a pretty simple man.
Yeah, but your idea of manhood is putting on an Eddie Cochran album and screwing your girl. I mean, it's not like that anymore. Women these days want other things.
Like what?
I don't know. Enya.
Ha!
Yeah. And it's...
What are you saying?
They got me at the Radisson in town.
Nice!
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
Lansing Film Festival.
Yeah, that, and then Cannes.
Still, that's a good gig.
It's a good cheap thrill.
Why you gotta dump on it? That's a good gig.
Because I have big expectations, Vince. I mean, I spent 2 years of my life on this film. I want it to be in a theater near you.
It is.
Yeah, but you had to drive to the middle of fucking Michigan for one screening, for which I'm getting paid like a whopping $500.
Yeah, but all you need is for some guy from, like, whatever, Disney to be there tomorrow, and he likes it. Boom! Next thing you know, you're directing Free Willy 4.
Starring David Hasselhoff!
Hey!
Oh, man. Dude, I'm starving.
What time is it?
Quarter up.
You want a beer?
Aren't you supposed to be getting your act together?
I'll do it when I get back.
You see, this is what Leah's talking
John,
about.
John, if I want to hang out with my mother, right?
Well said.
What Leah doesn't know won't hurt.
What do you got going on in this bag, Vince?
Beer.
How much?
Lots.
I don't know why I said you have violent tendencies.
Why?
I don't know. Warm beer, boxer shorts, Motel 6. Who needs Betty Ford?
Yeah, we can't all be at the Wattison.
You know if you wanted to stay with me, all you had to
do. No.
Look, the only reason I didn't offer is because
it's not a problem.
It's not a problem. Okay, look, they gave me a double. I'm on the 11th floor. I'm overlooking a park.
You probably want to get laid.
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, it's your big weekend. Chicks are gonna flock to you.
You are right.
I'll be fine here.
Fine.
Should I twist your arm?
Yeah, more.
Schmuck,
you prick.
Putz.
Suck ass.
Woo!
I really appreciate you coming out here, man. I mean, we've come a long way.
Since?
I don't know, high school?
Do you think?
Some of us. I'm totally giving you shit.
Nah, but you're right.
No, I'm not.
You are, face it.
I'm right only in that I think you could be doing a little better than you are.
Why?
Because I believe in you. Right? If I didn't, we wouldn't still be friends, and I wouldn't be able to say that to you.
Why not?
Because it sounds totally pretentious.
You're right.
The thing is, though, I mean it, alright? Look, I mean, it's like the same with Leah, you know? If it is permanent, you should look at it as an opportunity for change.
Change what?
Change your life a bit, you know? I mean, find a new job, a new way of doing things.
I like my job.
What is your job?
I'm volunteer firefighter.
Ugh, I know, but how do you make your money, Vince?
Lay off!
I'm just saying...
What?
It's immature.
You try doing it.
But that's not the point.
Besides, the majority of my clients happen to be over 50, so if that's not mature, I'm a little baffled as to what is.
Private dope delivery to ex-hippies does not a mature man make, Vince. I mean, it's not that different from standing down on the corner selling to teenagers.
Why are you lecturing me?
I'm not. I'm just pointing things out.
Such as
I think you can be doing better than you are.
Then what?
Then pissing your life away, man. You're a smart guy. Why are you still dealing drugs?
Because I'm smart. If I was dumb, I would have been caught by now. Besides, I'm a firefighter.
You deal to the fire chief.
He needs me.
But that is not the point.
Why is what you do better?
Why is what I do better?
Yeah.
What I'm trying to do is better because it's an attempt at figuring things out. All right, look, I would like to eventually become good enough at it to where I can contribute to the larger debate about why this country is so fucked up. You know, I would like to examine why it is that a 50-whatever-year-old fire chief feels the need to get high every night. You know, what is it about life in America driving that urge in him?
He likes it.
Fine, but then there's something wrong with someone with that type of responsibility, you know, being constantly high. There's maybe some sort of symbolism there worth examining.
This firehouse happens to have the best record in the city.
Vince, if my house was on fire, I wouldn't want his high ass anywhere near it.
You're such a fucking bigot!
The guy has a good record because he's lucky.
Says who?
It's obvious, man. He's living a big rock-driven life.
Are you high?
I'm serious!
You're making movies about people who rob Popeye's Fried Chicken!
I am aiming to tell a story which resonates a warning about where this country might be headed if we're not careful. The only reason that sounds pompous is because I haven't fully honed my skills yet, alright?
It doesn't sound pompous. It sounds like you're talking out of your ass.
Oh god, why?
Because you have no idea where society's headed. You're just like everybody else. You're following the latest trend which you hope will get you laid until that trend switches to something else, in which case then you'll drop the old one and then make a movie about whatever, like turtles getting caught in fishing nets, starring Cindy Hasselhoff, his niece.
You don't like my work?
I like it. I like a shot of whiskey in the morning. It's good for about 10 minutes, and then I want my coffee.
Wow.
What?
Did I say something to piss you off, or is it that you're just a dick?
Both.
Well, it's good to see you're finally admitting it.
Well, unlike some of us.
Wait, that I'm a dick?
Yeah.
When?
I'm speaking figuratively.
When was I figuratively a dick?
High school.
I was too shy to be a dick in high school.
I think you held your own.
That's because everyone's a dick in high school, Vince. I mean, it's like the white male football playing prerogative, you know? Look, the trick is to evolve into something else once you're out of high school.
You're wearing $300 shoes, John. Right,
that's not true.
Fine, 150?
I'm less shy than I was in high school.
So you're an overt dick?
No, I'm a thoughtful person who wears nice shoes.
And occasionally full of shit.
Is there something I'm not doing that you want me to be doing, Vince?
I don't want you.
Really? Because it seems like you're asking me to do something right now. Like a 28-year-old pot dealer who refuses to progress with the rest of the world is asking you to do something. And that would be all right, you know, if it was a legitimate rebellion instead of you just being a lonely guy hanging out in a motel room wearing boxer shorts acting like a potentially violent dick.
Do you want to get high?
No.
Come on, John, let's get high.
I'm not getting high, Vince.
Why not? Only violent dicks get high.
No.
So then come on, man, let's get high.
I'm not getting high.
I am.
What do you have in this bag, Vince?
Pot.
How much?
Lot. You know who's out here?
Where?
Here. Lansing.
Who?
Amy Randall.
Really?
Yep. Heard that from Tracy about 2 years ago, so when you got this thing, I looked her up. Apparently she's like an assistant county prosecutor or something.
Huh. Did you call her?
I thought about it.
Yeah, you should.
Yeah, especially now that Lee is...
out of the picture?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Hot?
Yeah.
Not a very politically appropriate way to think about women, John.
Alright, here's the thing with being appropriate. You know, it's better to try and do that than to be a complete asshole. You know, the choice to respect people is actually a good one. Unlike people like you who insist on calling fat people fat to their faces.
But what if they're fat?
If they're fat, then they probably already realize it without you having to tell them. I mean, it basically has to do with having a couple of manners.
Is that what it is?
Yeah, that's
so,
it.
Well, why'd you ask if she was hot?
Because she is. Was? The word is essentially a compliment, Vince, than saying it isn't bad manners. I mean, human beings like being called attractive, and I'm not labeling Amy Randall anything she doesn't already realize. I'm sure she's smart, too.
Well, you know, if we call her up and she weighs 320 pounds, I think we should say, gee, we're really glad we dated you in high school instead of now, because back then you were really hot and now you're just... I'm sure you already realize about now.
Maybe you should just shut up for a little while.
Oh, see, I made a point, so now I need to shut up.
Ugh, no, it's just that you like being rude for the sake of it. I mean, either that or you do it to prove nobody can make you be nice, but either way, man, it just gets a little tiresome. You know, I mean, you and I don't see each other often enough to make this whole competition for who's more authentic, worthwhile. Should just accept the fact that we're a little different from each other and, let the friendship go from there.
Accept the fact that we're a little different from each other.
Yeah.
Would you like to make me?
Make you what?
Accept that fact.
No.
Why not?
Because it's stupid.
No, it's not.
Yeah, it is.
No, it's not. Because how else would I know that you're different?
Oh, you're just gonna have to trust me on that one.
No, prove it.
Or what?
I don't know. We'll kick your ass.
Whoa. I guess this means you are potentially violent.
Only when it comes to you, John.
Funny how you get this way every time we talk about Amy Randall.
No, I don't.
Yeah, you do.
Fuck off.
Alright, you know what? I'm out of here.
Fuck off!
Yeah, it was good to see
fuck
you.
Fuck off!
Thanks for coming.
Fuck you, John!
Look, man, I'm sorry you still feel bad about Amy Randall. And every time you get high and drunk around me, you bring it up. But it happened 10 years ago! And I've told you a million times, I thought it was okay for me to be with her because you guys had broken up. Alright? But now that I have a better understanding as to the fragility of human emotions, especially those belonging to swarthy Italian-Americans like yourself, and you know what? Thus, if the situation arose again, I wouldn't let what happened happen. But these things do happen, Vince, and especially in high school. Sorry I hurt your feelings.
So what I'm talking about.
What are you talking about?
Talking about what happened.
So am I.
So then what happened?
We slept together.
How?
What do you mean?
How? Did you sleep together?
Oh god, now this is about that?
Isn't it?
Is it?
You tell me.
We slept together.
How?
You know how, Vince.
No, actually I don't. I mean, I have an idea, but I don't actually know because we've talked about it and we laughed about it, but you've never exactly told me what happened.
What do you want to know?
I want to know what happened.
We slept together.
How?
What do you mean, how?
How?
Oh god, you're gonna have to be more specific, Vince.
In what fashion did you sleep with her?
We had sex.
Yeah?
And that was it.
Was it good?
I've had better since.
Fun?
It was alright.
Was it on the rough side?
It's hard to say, alright? We were both pretty drunk.
Was you rape her?
No.
Kind of?
No.
Was it kind of like date rape?
Like date rape?
Like, did you kind of force her to have sex with
no.
her?
No!
John.
I'm not really sure what you want me to say here, Vince.
You're a filmmaker. I want you to lay out the scene for me, man. Show me the dailies, you know?
Can we talk about this sometime when you're not high?
Well, maybe the only reason I'm high is so that you get high, so that for once you can finally tell me what happened instead of changing the subject.
All right. Yes, okay. It was a little rough. Obviously something doesn't make me proud.
Did you ever talk to her after that?
No.
Why not?
I wouldn't know what to say to her, Vince. I'm a completely different person than I was then.
Maybe she is too.
Maybe.
Maybe she's fat.
That's not really fine.
I didn't say it was. Did you ever talk to her after that?
I didn't, no.
Tell anyone about it?
No, I didn't tell anyone.
When? Well, maybe you should.
Alright, look, I don't actually consider it a crime, Vince. Morally somewhat questionable. I wish it hadn't happened. I don't think it's the type of thing I need to turn myself into the police 10 years later.
I'm not talking about the police.
Then what are you talking about?
I don't know. Her?
I think she already knows.
So then maybe you should apologize.
Oh, Jesus.
What?
You want me to apologize?
Why not?
Jesus, it wasn't even... It wasn't date rape, Vince. It was just something that got a little out of hand. All right, look, I'm sorry.
Stop apologizing to me, John.
I'm not, okay? What I'm trying to say is 10 years ago I did something wrong, all right? When I look back on it now, it's like the person who did that is a complete stranger to me, alright? Just a dumb, drunk high school senior thought she was being a little prudish and needed a little coercion, but it's a far cry from rape. And I don't think she would look back on it and call it that either.
Well, what would she call it?
Ugh, I don't know what she would call it, Vince.
What if she called it rape?
Ugh, I highly doubt she even remembers it happening.
You remember it, John.
Yeah, okay, I remember it, but I remember it because it was a pivotal thing for me.
Yeah, your first rape!
Stop being an asshole!
Tell me why it was pivotal.
Because, alright, it was one of the first times I looked at myself objectively and decided I was going to avoid becoming a certain type of person. For her, it might not have been anything significant one way or the other, alright, but for me, it constituted something very significant.
So you'd like to think?
Why are you suddenly all high and mighty?
I'm not high and mighty. I'm too high to be high and mighty. Remember, I'm just the lowly, drug-dealing, boxer-wearing scum of the earth.
Yeah, you sounded...
No, actually, you did.
I didn't mean it like that,
Well,
Vince.
How did you mean it?
That you should change your life a bit.
This coming from a rapist.
Oh, you're an idiot.
No, sorry. This coming from a big, low-budget movie maker who makes movies about where society's potentially headed. If we could just manage to forget about that one rape, we kind of didn't really commit in high school.
You're seriously disturbed.
No, you know what? I was wrong before. I am high and mighty.
What do you want me to say, Vince? I'm sorry.
Stop apologizing.
I'm not apologizing. I'm apologizing in general, all right? Look, I don't think I'm an evil person.
No one's saying you're evil.
It sure as hell feels like it.
Do you think you're evil?
No.
So then you're not evil? I'm the evil one here. You're the morally conscious movie maker.
Oh, whatever.
No way.
Can we stop this now?
Totally.
Thank you.
I just think you should call her.
I'm not gonna call her, Vince.
I think you should.
Stop it, okay? To call her would be trivialize the entire thing. It would be like me saying, how's life? Oh, by the way, sorry I date raped
her. So you did date rape her?
No, I didn't date rape her.
Then what'd you do?
I coerced her to have sex with me.
How?
Verbally.
Verbally coerced her?
Yes, by applying excessive linguistic pressure, I coerced her to have sex with me.
And then things got rough.
Things got rough in that after a while they became aggressively playful.
They did.
We did.
Meaning what?
Meaning I probably still thought I was being playful, but other people might interpret my actions as a little rough.
Yeah, i.e. rape.
No, rough.
Look, John, only you two are there, so only you two can interpret your actions. So why don't you just tell me the facts, and then you can go back and interpret them later.
I am telling you the facts. I argued her into
it. You're fucking lying, Joe!
What is your problem?
How could you sit here with your oldest friend in the world and continuously tell lies?
What makes you think I'm lying?
Because only you would come up with the term excessive linguistic pressure. It's not a normal expression, John. It's a clear sign of excessive bullshit. I mean, if you had really done just that, you'd be more specific. You'd say you told her that if she didn't put out, you'd tell people that she had VD or smelled bad or had a penis.
What?
Or any of the other normal things that guys say. But you come up with your typical crap, which sounds mature, but it contains nothing. Because the whole reason you are where you are today is because you always insist on getting things your way. It's what you're good at, John. So just own up and admit what you did.
Fuck off, Vince.
Fine, I'll call it.
Don't do that.
Why not?
Because I would like you not to.
Why not?
Because you made your point.
What's
okay?
My point?
Your point is nobody's perfect, including me, and it offends you when I tell you how you should live your life.
No, not my point.
It should be!
Well, it's not!
Why not?
Because I haven't gotten to my point yet.
Then please get to it.
Maybe I'll know.
Then I'm gonna go.
Wrong.
Right.
Tell me what you did. Admit it.
Admit what?
What you did to Amy.
What makes you think I did anything?
Because I know.
Know what? How?
Because she told me.
Told you what?
What you did.
What'd she say?
What?
Yeah, what'd she say?
Nothing.
Yeah.
It was obvious. Tell me what you did.
Don't be a dick.
Tell me what you did.
Why do you care?
Because I want to hear it.
What would that change?
I don't know.
So we both know I did something wrong, so what is it? Oh.
Tell me what you did. Thank you.
What the hell did you just do?
Taped our conversation.
Why?
Because I wanted to make sure that I heard you right. You're right, John.
You're a completely different person.
I can't believe you just did that.
Beer? You're mad?
How could you do something like that?
Like what?
I'm not messing around, Vince.
Oh, it offends you?
Offends me.
Why? All I'm suggesting is that you call her up and apologize for the actions of a drunk high school senior.
You know that you just ended our friendship, right?
It's a cheap little case before it's Kmart, man.
Why did you do that?
Because I'm trying to make a point.
Which is what?
That there's something wrong here.
Where? With you and me?
Yeah, and everyone else!
Well, you think everyone else should just call up and apologize for everything they've ever done wrong in their life? You actually think that would make a bit of difference?
I don't know.
You don't think it would just be a bunch of hypocrites out there raping people and apologizing for it?
Do you have a better idea?
Yes. Don't do it next time.
That's it!
Yes, that's it!
You don't even think she'd want it for herself.
What?
The tape!
Why would she want that, Vince?
To know that you admitted it.
I doubt she even remembers it.
So then she might want to be reminded.
Why?
Because I would want to be reminded if you pinned down my arms and fucked me with
a... Don't talk like that!
That's what you did, John! It's on the tape!
This is ridiculous!
Why?
Because my calling and apologizing now is going to make a bit of difference to her, Vince. She's probably dealt with the whole issue and moved on.
Maybe she has. But if you're such a different guy than you were 10 years ago, then technically you should have no problem apologizing for something that, in effect, the real you didn't even do. Now, if you are still the same kind of guy who could do something like that, then I would understand you're being hesitant to apologize. I mean, you wouldn't want to come across as a hypocrite.
Give me that tape.
No.
Why?
Because, as you imply to me on a daily basis, whenever we spend the day together, I wouldn't have the guts to tell her all the interesting tidbits of information this tape here with contains. It'd be much easier to simply hand it to her, if I even have the guts to do that. You know, I think I'm gonna skip dinner. I'm not really that hungry.
You're not giving her that tape, Vince.
Hard to say.
Tell me what you're gonna do with it.
Hard to say!
Stop being a dick!
I'm sorry. Did you want some?
Tell me what you're gonna do with the tape.
Well, I was thinking about making it into a movie and applying it to next week's nights in the film festival. Seriously, John, you should go. I'll tell her you said it.
What are you talking about?
She should be calling at any minute.
Why?
Because she said she'd call me at 8.
I thought you said you didn't call her.
No, I said I thought about calling her, and I actually did. Seriously, John, I'll tell her you said it. And you know what else? I probably won't even go through with the whole thing unless, of course, she sees it sitting there and just keeps pestering me as to what it is. How are you? Cool. Well, hey, are you still up for some chow? Okay, well, hey, by the way, did I tell you the reason why I was out here? Mm-mm. That's right, the film festival, but the reason for that is, well, you remember John Saltzman, right? Well, he's actually made a movie that's being shown as a part of the festival, so I came out to do that. Yeah. Yeah, well, anyway, I don't know how you want to do this. I'm over at the Motel 6 on Saginaw, so... Exactly, so you know where it is. Well, if you're listening by, and pick me up from there, then... The only thing is I don't... Yeah. Okay. Alright, well, I'll see you in a bit. I'm in room 32. Dude, can I borrow a couple bucks?
Why are you doing this?
Well, at first it was a moral crusade. Now I'm not really sure, other than the fact that you don't want me to. Oh.
And that's worth more than our entire friendship.
John, if you weren't my oldest friend in the world, I don't think I would possess the power to make you think twice about something like this, assuming you are thinking twice.
There are better ways to go about that, Vince.
Oh, how? Convince you with a really good argument? Apply excessive linguistic pressure? I'm not a very moral guy, John, much less a highly articulate poet movie maker. I can barely pay my rent, much less persuade someone like you to stop being an asshole.
Nobody's asking you to be articulate, Vince. Except for you picked potentially the most important weekend of my entire life to bring up something I haven't thought about in 10 years.
Yeah, I guess so. Are you gonna stay here?
Give me the tape.
No.
Give me the tape, Vince!
Why?
Because it doesn't belong to you.
I bought it. Okay,
what's on it doesn't belong to you.
Oh, shit, I had to make all your fucking aims to make this tape. It's the most planned out thing I've done my whole life.
It's mine.
I'm gonna give it to you and you're gonna destroy it.
No, I'm not.
What are you gonna do? Put it in your closet? Not think about it for another 10 years?
Where do you get this whole self-righteous thing? It's not really like you to have much of a spine.
Yeah, well, what can I say? I'm a fireman.
Not leaving until you give it up.
Well, I don't care if you're not leaving, just don't finish my coke.
Tell me something, Vince. Have you ever done anything that you regretted?
Yes.
That you never apologized for?
Yes.
So why are you doing this now?
I don't know. It must be for all the guilt I have, for all the things that I never apologized for. And now I'm just taking it out on you.
Alright, so it's irrational.
I agree.
So give me the tape.
No fucking way, John! You know I wasn't even gonna give her the tape, but the way you're acting, it's like I have no choice.
Stop.
Susie, John, she was on herself.
Give
she
me the tape!
What? What?
Stop.
You can't do it any time, John. I won't get in your way this time.
Sit, sit!
Tracy's, right?
Right, that was 5 years ago.
Yeah, I couldn't make it that far.
You were in grad school.
USC.
Film?
Yeah.
Obviously. Lansing Film Festival.
Right, yeah, that's why I'm here.
Right, Vincent told me.
Right.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna wait outside,
no,
Vincent.
No!
I don't think I locked my car.
It's okay, I'm not here. It's fine, really. I mean, I'll just stand here. So,
yeah.
It's good to see you, Amy.
You too, Vincent.
So, why do you live in Lansing?
I like it. It's sort of mellow.
Totally.
I went to school in Ann Arbor.
That's right.
So, I just decided to stay.
Well,
I can admire that. Vince, he told me, but what kind of law is it?
I'm an assistant district attorney.
Right. Cool.
Yeah, I like it a lot.
Yeah?
I mean, it's a pretty good job.
So you basically prosecute criminals, then, yeah?
Yeah.
Right, cool.
So, what have you been up to, Vincent?
Me? Not much.
God, I can't believe you called me out of the blue like that this morning.
Yeah?
Yeah, I love it when people do that.
Why?
I don't know. I guess they don't have the courage to do that sort of thing.
I just figured, what the hell?
Yeah, but you could have easily not done it.
No, what?
Called. Most people don't.
Yeah, it's true.
It is.
Like John.
No, I didn't mean it here.
And if you had?
Probably one of those people who don't have, like, courage.
You think?
It's hard to say.
It is. You know, half the time it's not even worth it. People lose touch, wind up having nothing to say to one another, even if they were best friends the year before.
Well, I'm glad that you're not.
Is that right?
Yeah.
You should have seen me in college.
Fat?
Quite.
Me too.
Probably for different reasons.
Mm-hmm.
So you never answered my question.
Which one?
What have you been doing these days?
Oh, I live in California.
Where?
Oakland.
Nice.
I'm a firefighter.
Are you serious? That is pretty cool, Vincent.
Keeps me busy.
I'm sure.
Yeah.
Are there a lot of fires in Oakland?
Average.
So I'm gonna get going.
Dude, I thought you were coming to dinner with us.
No, I never said
well,
that.
Why don't you?
Because I have to get some sleep for tomorrow.
No, you don't.
Yeah, actually, I do.
Dude, they're showing your movie. You're not running a marathon.
I know that. But
besides, they're showing your screen at like 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
I know, but I have meetings in the morning.
You haven't changed at all, have you, Vincent?
What do you mean?
I remember you doing the same thing when we were dating.
Doing what?
Putting pressure on people to follow whatever schedule you've worked out in your head.
Okay, that's not true.
No, it is. But look, it's nice. It's like you stay up the night before thinking exactly how you want the day to work out. Now you just want to stop partaking in your vision.
Okay, that's not true, Amy.
Oh, okay.
John can do whatever he wants.
I know.
I mean, I'm just suggesting that he joins us for dinner.
Why?
Because I'm sentimental. I like it when those friends get together.
Maybe John doesn't feel like it.
Well, I know he doesn't feel like it because he lacks the courage. It's like you said, he lets things go.
I didn't mean him specifically.
Well, you should have. He always does it.
Does what?
Let things go. If you saw your mother in the street, you'd cross to the other side.
What are you, high?
A bit.
You're high right now, Vincent?
Yes.
You've been smoking pot since high school.
It's no different than drinking.
Do you still drink?
So?
I'm just saying you still, you know, should be careful.
What is this, lecture Vince night?
Who's lecturing you?
You are, and he did. I'm waiting for the Motel 6 desk guy to get in here next.
It's just because I care about you, Vincent.
You haven't seen me for 5 years.
Yeah, but it's inevitable. You were my first boyfriend. You know, you could turn into a dirty old man and I'd still care.
Really?
Yeah, it's just one of those things.
So do you want to get married?
I can't right now.
Why not?
I have a boyfriend.
Who's he?
The district attorney.
That is so typical.
Why?
I don't know. It just
well,
is.
If it doesn't work out, I'll call you in Oakland.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, okay. I am going to get going.
Him a lecture.
On what?
Taking better care of himself.
Looks like he's doing okay.
It's good to see you.
Me too.
Whoa.
Vincent.
No, he's not getting out of here just like that.
I'll see you tomorrow?
No, bullshit.
Vince.
It's actually
I have to go.
To say that, Amy. You know, I always thought that John was your first love. I mean, I know you guys didn't really date that much, and I didn't know about it until way later, but I always assumed that when you guys got together that at the end of senior year, it was like some sort of long-awaited love affair that was bound to happen. Am I characterizing that?
I don't think anyone here would call it a long-awaited love affair, Vince.
What would you call it?
I would call it us getting together at the end of senior year.
Oh, and you know, I'm just jealous because I wanted to be your first boyfriend.
You were.
I know, but you know what I mean. I shouldn't care about that kind of stuff, but it's like I say, sentimental.
That's not sentimental, Vincent.
No, what is
it's
it?
It's stupid.
I agree. But see, you not wanting to sleep with me back then was kind of like being disinvited to Christmas dinner at my grandparents' house, which I'm very sentimental about.
You shouldn't have taken it personally.
I know, but I did. Especially when you guys ended up getting together. Literally. But I guess I blew it out of proportion.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about when you guys got together there at the end of senior year. It hurt my feelings at the time, but according to John, It was less of a long-awaited love affair and more like two kids getting giddy before graduation. In which case, I shouldn't hold a grudge. Is that what it was?
I would say it was a crush that didn't amount to much.
For you or for him?
For me.
Hence, it doesn't really seem like she wants to talk about this.
Why not? We're all mature adults here. We can talk about a little high school crush that happened 10 years ago.
All right, fine. Then I'm gonna let you two decide.
Fine. Before you go, I want to know why nothing ever came of Amy's crush for you. Amy?
Why nothing ever came of it?
Yeah, why didn't it develop into something else? I mean, it's not like you and I got back together afterwards. I don't even think you dated anyone after that.
Just didn't work out.
Oh. And there's no specific reason for that.
I'm sure there was.
What?
No, but I'm sure there was.
Oh. Why are you so anxious to leave, John?
Because this is awkward for me, Vince.
And so you'd rather leave.
All right, fine. You know what? I'm here. Okay? Does anyone have anything they want to say to me?
Thanks.
Vince?
Yep. It's your call, John. I can't speak for you.
It was good to see you in here.
That is so fucking typical. John?
What?
Can I have that back?
Safe place.
Why?
There don't seem to be enough fires to keep you busy.
What do you mean?
Can you tell me what that was about?
I wanted to know what happened between you two.
When?
That night. I wanted him to apologize to you.
Why?
So you could hear it. He admitted it to me.
What did you do?
I got him to admit it. It's on the tape.
Admit what?
What he did to you. He did do it, didn't he, Amy? Am I wrong? He raped you, didn't he?
Why would that be any of your business?
You're missing my whole point.
Even if he had, the last thing I would want is a taped confession.
Why not?
Because I'm not the one who needs it.
What do you mean?
I'm not the one who needs it.
So then who needs it?
I'll see you later.
Where are you going?
Home.
Well, I don't think you understand. I'm trying to do the right thing.
For who?
For you.
Is that really what you mean, Vincent?
Of course it's what I mean.
Because I don't think it is.
I thought you'd appreciate it.
Well, I don't.
Why not?
Because he didn't rape me.
What?
He didn't. So the only person that you're trying to make feel better is yourself.
Hey, hey, what are you doing here?
I came back.
Why?
Because it felt like it. Vince, can you give us a couple minutes in private?
Are you kidding me?
No, I'm serious.
Do you want me to leave you alone with her?
Yes.
No.
Why not?
Because of the whole no. No. No fucking way!
I just need 2 minutes.
Why?
Because I want to tell her something.
What?
It's none of your business.
Yes, it is.
Why?
Because I'm the one who brought it up.
Vincent, it's fine.
No, it's not.
Yeah, it is.
Well, I don't care. I'm not leaving.
I wanted to apologize.
For what?
Vince?
What?
Just shut up! I wanted to apologize. For what it's worth, I'm sorry. I really, truly, honestly am.
For what?
For what happened between us in high school.
What happened between us?
I'm talking about what happened at the end of senior year, which is what Vince was trying to get me to talk about before.
Before when?
Like 5 minutes ago.
About when you and I got together in high school?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, tell me again what happened.
Do you remember the day I'm talking about?
At the end of senior year, Rebecca's party.
Yes.
Right.
What are you guys doing?
I'm just curious. I don't want there to be a communication gap here.
I don't really know what I'm supposed to say.
I think you did something.
Yeah.
What do you think you did?
Why?
Because this is very interesting to me.
Wait, do you not think something happened?
Well, of course something happened.
Are you saying you don't remember what it was?
Oh, come on, John. There are certain things one doesn't forget.
I agree.
I'm just wondering how you would describe it.
Probably the same way as you.
You think?
Okay, look, the whole reason that I came back is because Vince taped this conversation that he and I had earlier.
Dude, I'm sorry.
It's fine.
I didn't realize.
I'm just saying that that is why I am here.
You're here because Vince taped you.
Yes.
Why?
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 Because it made me think.
Oh.
Which is why I came back.
Good, so tell me what happened.
I think I raped you.
No. You didn't rape me.
Yes, I did.
No, you didn't.
Amy, I know. Are you making fun of this?
No.
I know what happened.
Apparently not.
Yes, I do.
Says who?
Me.
Why?
Because I just admitted it.
On what, the tape?
Yes.
What's on it?
It's me confessing what I did.
What did you do?
I just told you that.
That doesn't prove you did it.
Why not?
Because if no one is accusing you of anything, there's no reason to confess.
Okay, I'm having trouble realizing what you're doing.
I'm not doing anything.
Amy, this is not an easy thing for me.
You sure about that?
John.
What?
Do you realize what you're saying?
I'm saying what you wanted me to say.
I know, but are you sure you have the right girl?
Yes!
She says nothing happened.
She's lying.
No, I'm not.
Amy?
What?
You're mocking this.
Why would I do that?
I don't know, but if you are, I have better things to do.
I just think we have different perceptions of what really happened.
I really don't see how that could be.
Why? Because you say you did something?
I did do something.
Well, I say you didn't.
Then what happened?
We had sex.
Amy, I'm trying to be honest.
Why now?
I haven't seen you in 10 years.
Why now?
Because when he played the tape back for me, it hit me what I had done.
And if he hadn't played back the tape,
yeah.
Would you be saying this?
I don't
or
know.
Is it that I'm standing right
what
here?
What do you mean?
If I had lived in Alaska, would you have sought me out?
Don't know.
No, you should look into that.
Fine.
Maybe it's because you're jealous.
Of what?
Of Vincent and I.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
Is it? Huh? I loved you. I was totally in love with you that night. Did you love me back?
No.
Then why were you with me?
I'm not really sure.
Maybe it's the same reason you came back to apologize just now.
Which is what?
You like pissing off Vincent.
Why would it piss him off, Amy? It's the very thing you wanted in the first place.
Because he's confused.
Exactly.
It's never too late to one-up your best friend by telling him once and for all that you raped the love of his life in high school, especially if you get to do it in front of her.
You really think I'm like that?
I don't know. I have a poor record of judging you accurately. Maybe you came back to get the last word. You don't like what's on the tape, so you wanted to hear yourself phrase it more eloquently.
I came back to apologize, all right? Which I assure you is not at all disingenuous. I honestly am sorry.
Why? Because you had your hand on my mouth?
Yes.
Well, hey, John. I let everybody do that.
Can you please just tell me the truth?
I am.
Where are you going?
I think I should leave.
Why?
Because no matter what I say, Vince, there's no one for this to go.
You want the last word, John, but it's not yours to have.
Why don't you guys just figure out what the fuck you're talking about?
Vince.
What?
She's in denial.
Amy.
What is it that even made you think something happened that night?
At Rebecca's?
Yeah.
Because I thought it did. I thought later that's what you were trying to tell me.
Why?
Because why else did you have slept with John when you were supposed to be dating me?
Vincent, you and I had been broken up.
I know, but you and I hadn't even slept together, so what the hell were you doing sleeping with him?
That's none of your business.
Well, that's partly why I thought something had happened.
Why? Because I'm not sleeping with you? Why should I be sleeping with anybody else?
Yeah, I guess. I thought something like that.
Oh, my God.
Okay, I am going. Maybe I'll see you tomorrow. Amy, I'm sorry. And I'm sorry you're not in a place to hear that right now. I hope you have a good life.
What? Why did you say that?
Say what?
That I'm not in a place to hear it.
Because you don't seem to realize that I mean it, okay? I don't know how to say it to you any other way than I've already said it. And if it really isn't that big of a deal to you, I need you to know that it was for me, okay? And I honestly am sorry.
Well, you should be. And I hope you die for it and go to hell. And if there is no hell, I hope you suffer. on your way to death, and that your last living sensation is that of a steel rod being shoved repeatedly up your insides so that it batters your heart and punctures your stomach, and when you die and your sphincter finally collapses, I hope that your last bowel movement be saturated with the draining backwash of your rotting, fucking, pathetic guts!
Along the lines of something you wanted.
I don't know what you want me to say to you.
Nothing.
Yes, hi, this is Amy Randall from the DA's office. Can you please dispatch a squad car to the Motel 6 on Saginaw, room 32? There seems to be a significant amount of illegal substance in the room, what appears to be cocaine. You might also want to run a check on one of the two gentlemen here, John Saltzman, S-A-L-T-Z-M-A-N, possible history of sexual misconduct, the verified first degree CSC 10 years prior. Thank you. You guys can make a run for it if you like.
Did you really just do that?
Average response time in Lansing is 4 minutes. It's one of the top departments in the country.
Why does it have to be like this?
Because if you're truly repentant, you should be willing to pay the price.
Why can't you just accept the fact that I'm sorry?
Because it does me no good.
Is that my fault?
No, just the way it is.
But I'm the one that has to run out here like a criminal?
That's up to you. Is that because you think the statute of limitations ran out?
I have no idea.
Because there is none for sexual misconduct felony.
Okay. I really don't feel like getting busted.
Well, I'll see you later, Vincent. Owen, can you leave that tape behind so I can give it to Officer Friendly?
You want me to give you the tape?
Yeah. You don't need his permission.
I feel like I do.
You didn't need his permission to make it, so why do you need it now?
Protocol.
Fine. I'll stay here and tell him myself.
Dude, come with me.
I'm staying.
Why?
Because maybe she's right, alright? But maybe I should pay the price.
Fine, but what about me?
What about you, Vince?
I didn't really do anything wrong.
You're in possession of illegal substance, Vincent.
I know, but I was just trying to blow off some steam.
You should have blown it off with beer.
I did! I was blowing off a little extra. Don't be an idiot, we'll arrest you. Come with me.
No.
Is this really what you want?
John's a big boy, Vincent. He can make his own decisions.
Sure. Sure, Vince. Vince, thank you.
What?
Thank you.
For what?
All your honesty.
What are you talking about?
Never mind. Maybe I'll see you later.
Fuck! Did you really call the police?
No.
Jesus Christ! Oh,
sorry.
Why would you do that?
Because I felt like it.
Oh, do not want these drugs cost?
There will be other drugs.
I know. Oh, I really like these ones.
Good to see you.